Hey everyone, hope you're doing well. It's your main man Fuzzy on Tony coming back with another reaction. A few weeks ago, I reacted to my debut mixtape, 980. That was more of an attempt to make serious music. Before that, I was making a lot of joke and comedy songs that only me and my friends knew. It was basically references me and my friends knew, and also inside jokes we would tell each other. They did contribute to it. Sometimes they would add their verses. Since we traveled a lot in band, I actually brought my phone and I was recording on the app Soundtrap. I would put on a beat and they would just rap over that or sing or do whatever. They would also direct me and in a way executive produce the whole thing. The whole time period I was making this stuff, I think it was like at least 2 years, and I kind of made some stuff along the way after that. But like everything, it ran its course and I just left it be afterwards. The origin of how I started making this music was basically Savage Mac got some of my videos and he made some YTPs with that. And I wasn't really a big fan of it first, but afterwards I just accepted it and embraced it. And Savage was like, I need you to make an intro song. I was scouring the internet to find anything to record and I found Soundtrap. The rest is history. Now as I go down the mixtape, I will be giving you guys the backstory and process of how it was made, because it is truly remarkable in a one-time deal. Like, for real. You probably see the amazing graphic design is my passion thumbnail here. It's like an MLG gaming stage. And the text, oh god, the text is amazing. You got two of the bros there at the bottom. I photoshopped this picture out of a band picture. And I photoshopped myself in the center of the stage. Oh boy, this is just a joy to see. And you got Savage Mac over here, just his head peering over, shooting lasers. How even more crazy can it get? So I will say the names they went by here during this time. Now, Brian here, he actually went by Critics as his stage name. Abimel actually went by Superfet as his stage name. Savage Mac, he actually went by Samurai Suck as his first moniker, before he kind of started switching it up. But his name is actually Lamech. Pretty much I made this entire thing with my limited equipment, which was a potato laptop, not even a decent one. You could imagine all the hurdles I had to go through, but made it work still. Without a further ado, I might as well start.
I'm about to tell you one of the most amazing.
I forgot. I actually made a monologue for these two.
I'm about to tell you one of the most amazing stories ever known to mankind.
I forgot. I actually made this into a monologue as well.
Of a boy who got finessed and that would change his life forever. It wasn't easy for this man. He took the art of finesse and used it to his advantage. It's
been a long theatrics journey. Are crazy. Journey.
But he doesn't give up.
It's pretty much the bare minimum of a lot of these self-help motivational speeches.
Just the meaning of life. And it all simply started with...
Hey, yo, Antonio, dog.
Okay, so I actually told Brian here, I was like, I'm making a mixtape, I'm going to include all the songs that I did, well, the well-known songs, because I made like so much songs, some of them didn't even make sense. I basically chose the ones that stood out and kind of followed the story.
So Lamech made a fucking YTP account, bro, called Samurai Suck, and that shit is just hilarious, bro. He made one about white chicks, bro. You should check it out. It's fucking hilarious.
So you went to check out that video.
Oh my god, even the guitar that you just heard right now, that was somebody that was in our group as well. Like, he was just playing guitar and I just quickly recorded it and I just tossed it on here as background music. That's pretty innovative.
Video. He liked it, so he decided to show support to his Fifi. and he left a comment.
A lot of the lingo words that we use, it was basically words we were using. A lot of people didn't understand it, but that's the charm of it.
But what he didn't know was that that comment would change his life forever and start a new legacy amongst him.
Oh my god, dog. You literally just got wrecked, bro. Sorry, brother. This is the funniest shit ever, bro. They made a YTP of you. You need to check it out. It's literally like the best thing I've ever seen in my life, dog. Check it out.
Okay, so this actually did happen. Brian actually showed me Lamech's channel, and I just commented. And I think Lamech went through my entire channel, and he found all the videos I was doing, and he decided to make a YTP. I just arrive at school next morning, and we all met up at the band room. And I just see Brian just laughing hysterically. And then he looks at me and he's like, bro, you're going to hate me for this. And then I just look at what he was looking on his phone. And it was that YTP Lamech made of me. It's crazy where we find a start, huh?
After that day, Sosa thought his career was over. And he thought it got ended by that one man that goes by the name of Samurai Suck. But then Samurai Suck gave him a chance and to go make a cover song for his channel. And that's when things began.
Okay, so yeah, these are like the early songs that I made. And it kind of goes into like a compilation. Think of it as a quick montage.
After that, he launched more songs. A little bit, whatever he could, the production, everything.
When I first started recording these songs, I had no idea. I had like this karaoke microphone, and I thought it was connected to my computer, but it was actually using like the computer microphone, the one from the laptop that's built in. I had no idea. I thought it was a karaoke microphone, so I ended up buying a USB microphone on eBay and started recording the music. Oh my god. Let me give you guys the backstory to a lot of these songs. The reason I started making them was kind of a parody of how easy it was really to make a rap song and emulate what a lot of these rappers were doing. Well, I did my attempt, and I'm actually impressed with a lot of it because I had little to no knowledge, but I still found a way to make an attempt. A lot of the times I would also try to have similar rhyme schemes as the lyrics of the original songs with my lyrics, which don't make any sense, but that's the point of it.
Don't you dare touch my Timbs, yo. Or I'ma crip stomp you like a cantaloupe. Copy and steal is all we know. In the hill is all we know. Bro, we are too far gone. You are what? It's low key and scenes go. So don't you dare touch my Timbs, yo. Or I'ma crip stomp you like a cantaloupe. Party on sneaker.
Oh my god. I forgot. I actually added so much reverb to these beats as well. I added reverb to every single beat I touched.
Days, got a ton. Do it all again the next day.
Day
too far. I just wanna see the weekend. XO1. I might have to fuck now.
Crip stomp it.
They put my mixtape on repeat. Woo! These clothes that fit unique.
Versace.
I don't do no old shows.
So yeah, I was trying to emulate Travis Scott. Obviously.
They drive me loco. John Cena. I just want to remember. Later stunning. Who just passed before? Who that is? If they got brands, yeah, bruh, bruh, bruh. So don't you dare touch my Timbs, yo.
Yeah.
Or I'ma crip stomp you like a cantaloupe.
Yeah.
Copy and steal is all we know. In the hair is all we know.
Hollywood.
Bro, we are too hardcore.
You are what?
It's low key and see it's gone.
I'm impressed because even though Antidote is much better produced, like my attempt at it, it just almost sounds pretty uncanny. So yeah, at the night show, I would say at CSGO. Cause a lot of it was pro gaming, that was the theme. Even like the harmonies though. Damn.
Anything can happen at CSGO. Everything can happen at CSGO. CSGO, ooh, all Twitch not at home, just for CSGO, ooh.
All Twitch.
Scope it up, bro, ooh, how to match a fight for CSGO, ooh.
Bro, I like the cadences, actually.
Dotto's got a snipe, though, wind slipping fight, yo.
Oh, God, I actually forgot I did that. Now, they were listening to this song on the bus. When that part came, people were questioning me. They were wondering if I was okay.
I ain't got a smite, bro. Only got one fight, though. I will wreck you twice, yo. Slit!
At CSGO. At CSGO.
At CSGO. At CSGO. At CSGO. Racket of Dilly go dicker, you know I got spit it, go dicker, be raiding, they stating, debating. Won't be for second, we're trying to faking. Cold up and bad, they like to be slating. Calling me lazy and super persuasive, kicking crumbs out of my stages. The lately he be rushing at me like an Ingus. I'm really bored and I need a vacation. Over with my scopers receiving high wages. And winning with bros is all what we waited. Like all of the riches about to be waited. In town, I got you, bro. And you semi suck like a number one. Let's unite, got a no scope. If you wanna choke, I got a Nike, yeah. Copy steals is all we know. In the hill is all we know.
High
one. Bro, we are too hardcore.
You are what?
It's low key and see us go. So don't you dare touch my tins, yo. Or I'ma come stomp you like a pillow.
I'm still stunned that even for an attempt, I had no idea what I was doing. I had little knowledge of music production, and I was just tweaking it in there. And still kind of managed to figure out something.
Put some respect on my name. You understand me?
Oh,
y'all
God.
Say my name, put some respect on my
name. Savage Mech or Lamech, he actually used to make a lot of videos about Big Narsty, which he's a rapper from the UK. And also an internet personality. He would just make remixes of the coughs he would do. Because this guy would cough on a whole nother level. And I just decided to make a quick beat with his coughs. This one actually has original beats that I made. Which are pretty limited because, like I said, I had very limited equipment.
Tony coming back ever since Cantaloupe. Tracks coming soon, back sounding even though. Rolling down my foreign with my filthy prank. I have to finish.
I can't believe it would be the beat out of this.
That tune, but don't forget the old.
Did I say filthy Frank? Oh God, when I dropped this, this was like at the height and the beginning of the end of the edgy YouTube era. It's really a staple, really.
Finish, chill out, bro, it's just a prank. Samurai, critic, 69, and super fat. Careful, we're through to the R3.
It just sounds like that one Roach meme, though, where he's just, like, going with auto-tune.
Hey, the beat go off?
Hey. Motherfucking nigga things here wanna touch me. Bitches wanna go to my house and fuck me. I am a motherfucking superior king. Motherfucker wanna go.
I just tossed in the distorted sound in there as like a form of a bass. That's legendary.
My bling bling, nigga wanna fuck. Bam, nigga. I'm gonna pull up and bam. Like, cheap keep shining back, nigga. Gonna go out top.
Y'all finished or y'all done?
That was a quick and interesting song, wasn't it?
No.
I gotta talk to you guys about this. Because before, I couldn't say anything. Because when this happened, it just happened at school and we just kept it there. But I think I could tell you guys the backstory of a lot of the lyrics and what we were freestyling about.
What the hell is that?
Okay, so this is Brian. It's his part.
Yo! Always want to finesse me, man. Come on. Yo. Is that why your ass got fired? What about your God?
So this was actually our last game, our last competition, actually. And the main person for Color Guard or Auxiliary, like, this guy was, he was just so unlikable, to put it in terms. Like, even the Color Guard themselves did not like being around him and was not really professional. And also, he was pretty hard-headed when he went to confront us. Like, I legit remember he went up to Brian and then Brian kind of like talked back to him. And then this guy just went up to Brian and he was like, what did you say? What did you say? And he just tried to act tough. On the last competition, they just sat the guy down and said, you know, like, this is going to be the last time you're here and, you know, you're out. And it was like really hilarious. Ironically, the band director started the first year we started high school and ended when we ended high school, which is pretty funny. You could tell Brian has a lot of venom when it comes to this verse because he had a bone to pick with this guy because this guy was really unbearable.
Let us all down, man. Jason Pierce, man. Where it at? We're all damn trash, man. Right. Can't wait to get out of here, man. You know what I'm saying?
Boom.
Ladies, smell like ass.
Okay, so this is Abimo, and he's trying, but he just gives up halfway through.
Yo, all right.
Okay, so this guy, his name is Tinker. I think I could say that. He went by the moniker of Tinkerbell, because that's what we used to call him all the time. Ooh, he just goes full out on him. Just listen to this.
Okay. Mr. V said not to mess with him. But boy, that was excellent.
So excellent was one of the scores, and I think it basically just meant mid performance. That's what it really meant. And since this guy's job was questionable as a color guard instructor, it really came back to bite him. And we were given a mid score overall as our last performance. Poor was the lowest score you could get.
Oh my God.
Okay. You ain't got no job.
Yeah.
Got a curb stop.
Yeah.
I ain't playing.
Go.
I ain't trained.
Go.
Oh yeah, and I'm doing ad libs in the background. I'm like gang gang.
But I'm laying. Super hot fire.
Yeah.
Put me on the track.
Yeah.
I make a rack.
Bang.
Where do I sign? Nigga, I'ma put the paper on the line.
Yeah.
Black, black. Right. Hit me on
bang,
the line.
Bang.
Bang. Bang. Fuck around on 28.
Bang, bang.
Cause if you fuck around on 38.
Bang.
Bang. Bang.
I don't mess with Hugo.
Yeah.
Now, I actually still talk to Hugo. I think he also goes by Hugo the Humble One, that he's also known as. And at this time, like, Tinker just decided to roast him just because. There's, like, really no reason. And really, there's no bad blood. It was just, like, a joke, really.
This fake-ass nigga. Always trying to pull on the trigger.
Woo!
But, nigga, that's not how you hit.
All right. Oh.
You be the judge of what you think that means. This one was actually fun, and I just wanted to include it because I recorded this on my phone and just uploaded it as a freestyle. It was really fun. What? How do I just start a song like this?
Well, 'cause you did what you say.
By the way, a lot of these songs, sometimes the volume will be low and sometimes it would be like really loud. That's what the entire squad wanted me to do. They just wanted me to mess with the volume, and you guys will see what I mean. And I'm just tossing like so much memes at once.
my cup.
I just want to come
suck. I like how that was just out of nowhere. That was pretty funny.
You have to prove the choices you choose. Fool me once. Shame on you.
Was that Trump? Is that Trump in the background? I also sampled Trump. He's like, wrong, wrong. He's, oh man, this was that peak, wasn't it?
Fool me twice. I'm a 3-6.
We got Big Narcy and the psych guy. Oh my god, it's such a cluster.
See no scope, you. We the sus squad, not Bard Quad. You can forget about Trek, cause we about to wreck.
And yet, don't mind the Imogen Heap sample. I just tossed her in there.
Pineapple and pen. We can do it all over again.
Pineapple and pen. Oh, God. Pineapple and pen. I made a lot of references during this time period. It's crazy.
Team Fortress 2, not number 3. Watch my 3-peat. Supreme Tim's on fleek. Like, was that New York? Got a new score. Yeah, those are my outdoor exports. Don't worry, girl, we are experts.
Talking street too. What is going on? What is going on?
What you say?
That's what I was telling you guys about. Oh my god. You guys could see what I was talking about. Why is so low? It just sound, oh my god. Out of nowhere. Okay, that's what Savage Mac was doing with his videos, and I just try to emulate that. Am I weird ad living? What is Imogen Heaps? Or is it Imogen? I'm sorry if I butchered her name. But why does her song sound like that? I really went up for that register. Jesus, I forgot I used that as well. Okay, so that's screaming meme. I gotta be up front with you all. This was a meme we would always play, we would listen to, even to all the variations they made of it, and I decided to make my own. And just toss it in every which way. Which one's this one? Knowledge. Oh, I also sampled Brian and Lamech had a Call of Duty match. And I just sampled a lot of their voices and sound effects from that. Wait, was that? Is it Punjabi MC? I think it was him. Is it because of the Dictator movie? Jesus. That there's so much going on here. What was that? I forgot what I did. What did I do? I'm even questioning what I was doing. I tossed in so many things together, hoping I would form something. It's just a bunch of noise, but it's It's a masterpiece. I love it.
No, I don't sound like ASAP Rock.
Oh, yeah, I forgot I made this one. This one actually sounds really good.
50-50 chance to win the lottery. About a cruise up in that Ferrari. Flow sicker than a Yogati. Turn up, we about to be litty. While your vocals keep the same sound as Fetty. Bars coming out like Scope, yeah, it's heavy.
Why your vocals get the same sound as Fetty? I think that was a reference to Tory Lanez, since he had a song. Well, he tried to copy every single rapper, but I remember he had a song where he tried to copy Fetty Wap. I thought it was Fetty Wap at first, but it wasn't.
If I'm on same one for all two kids, turn up like Lil Wayne, dressed like a skater. Scrubs be the same, shout out to Tyler, the creator. You listen to my music, yeah, you say you're a hater.
Oh, yo, that actually is pretty good.
Scrubs try to flex, I'm a fan and scare wrecked. You're lucky, guess I won't digress. Came out of the Supreme store, hit your face with skateboard.
The original song is Travis Scott, the N out of Birds in the Trap, if I remember.
I'm gonna have to pull up on you with the Tims. The Tims, you're gonna have to make me finesse.
Okay.
Sam, I'm about to do it, bro.
You know what? I know I added reverb to this beat, but there's a few times where it actually sounds like it really fits.
I'm about to do it, bro. I don't really care. I'm about to say it. I'm about to say it. You know I go harder than Gucci Mane. I ain't gonna sugarcoat it. I ain't no candy cane. All you ignorant scrubs will call me insane. I'ma go far in you because I sell propane.
Okay, that was actually really fitting.
Just wrecked, I don't know why. Chief Keef.
No, we don't want beef with Chief Keef, really.
Now Charlie Brown, oh good grief. Samurai suck, about to surpass Leafy.
Oh my god, Leafy! This is really a product of its time. And Leafy is back, but he's just on Rumble and just saying dumb stuff all the time.
Fun to hit up Zoomies, two rocks to see. Never underestimate such a tea, but a cop. Every single Supreme T, yeah.
Yo, okay,
call me a hype beast. You're only second place. Second player, Mario Shadow Luigi. Yeah, bro. As long as the squad's here,
I forgot how good this beat was.
Every day's a lit day with the squad. And we're not afraid to team up together with our Tims.
Alright, so I gotta explain the lore with the Tims. I guess since Brian is from New York, Tim's became kind of like how everybody emphasizes the energy that Black Air Force Ones give. That's what Tim's were to us. It was really like this godlike energy, and we use it as a symbol of strength and power.
That's what the squad is, bro.
I remember I just uploaded after school and we were supposed to meet up at Cheesecake Factory. They were just like listening to it over there and like, oh, this is actually pretty good. Not Joey. No, not Joey too.
Sus. Sus.
Oh God. I made a parody of every single rapper. Imagine if I dropped this at the peak of Among Us pandemic year. It would have skyrocketed, especially with the sus and the keyword, the SAO. Ooh, don't get me started.
I beat that Timberland checker. First,
why do I sound
like
constipated?
Production like Kanye West, but I'm more wrestler. Don't compare me to Guava, be a real hustler. Sign me to hope that J. Cole no feature. I'm
gonna
let
it up
no like
features.
I play
either.
Critics on your whereabouts, tell them what we're all about. We the MLG bros, YTP bros, that'll stay around.
Such young ways, Kanye West. Too busy to test, but your ignorance still bliss. Yeah, I gotta get fixed now.
Go live with Meek Mill. Oh, I think I remember. I was listening Meek Mill a lot because this was when he had the beef with Drake and he lost, and everybody was just clowning on him. Now, don't get me wrong, Meek Mill still says and does some stupid stuff, but like during the peak of this, there was really no redemption arc from him during this time. I just sampled the bros in here.
This be the tank that I'm dropping, hotter than hot pockets, seeking missiles locking, G-force uncocking, boys stop and fight it, you know I signed it, your career I bought it, and I won't stop till I reach subconscious.
Subconscious. Oh, yeah, I remember Brian told me to throw in Link in there. As if he was a screaming meme that you guys heard earlier. Oh my lord. Again, it's that Call of Duty sample. Is this one? Wait, is this the life? Jesus Christ, this is the life. Well, it's not really live, but I made it sound live. This one is gonna be really interesting. Wait, is that the designer beat? I think that was the designer beat.
Sorry guys, I'm gonna do something a little bit different. All right, first of all, I wanna ask, who here knows Lex Steel?
Oh God, no, please.
I'm gonna kick you out of my show.
When I emulated this as a live show, I wanted to parody Travis Scott and Lil Uzi Vert when they use autotune in their shows. And this is about to get good.
I wanted to do something special. I wanted to do a tribute to Lex Steel. Sam, I'm going to need you to cut off my autotune for a second. Come on, bro. Just cut off the autotune. I want to do this. Alright guys, I need you guys to zim it down. I need full concentration for doing this.
The crowd, bro, the freaking crowd sample. That is hilarious.
In honor of Lex Steel, I gotta do this, man.
Oh, they shut right up.
I'm about to do it.
Damn it, I just remembered. I think they told me to do that. The squad told me to do that. I wonder what my neighbors at the time were thinking when they heard me record that. Yeah, and I'm just raging and ad-libbing through the whole song. Wow, that was beautiful. Okay, so this is a skit, and I actually added modulation to the song, which is why it sounds trippy.
Alright, so another part of my adventure was with gaming. I wasn't really too big into gaming, but once I started, you know, my project and everything, my whole career as I like launched it, like gaming like took part of me. I don't know how, but gaming took part of me, and it's made a big impact in my life, and you'll be surprised on how much it has impacted me.
Okay. Not Young MA 2. No way. Did I just parody everybody? What is this one called? MLG? Oh, Pro Gamer. I do have a song that's called MLG, I think. Okay, so yeah, this section of the mixtape, I think it's primarily just video game themed. At least with a lot of the culture.
Super fed stacking all bricks on Roblox. Crocs that you rock are a fashion faux pas.
samurai.
I actually have Crocs right now. What does that make me?
Ryan, I are the trendsetters. Fashion and music back off you better. Flying a banshee, oh, actually, we the OGs. Sending the YTPs, stacking the T's on Tetris. After playing Wii Tennis, playing Call of Duty just to finesse. You can't even scare critics on Slender. Dropping all the fruits and falling on the blender. Oh boy, on melee, I choose right. Ha, critics by the wreck, Soulja Boy!
Why did I just diss Soulja Boy? So I just made a lot of like gaming references.
We're the pro gamers. Boy, don't you care? We're the pro gamers. Woo! Woo! Hey, is this the pro right ad lib now? Alright.
Oh god. That was extensively long.
Hello, anybody?
Xbox controller skit.
What is this? Why is there a gaming system here?
Wait. Is that the Jaws theme? It's the Jaws theme distorted. I think I boosted the bass in this one.
Oh, that's an Xbox. Oh, it's the 360s. Oh my god. That's the OG, bro. Bro, the controller looks really dope.
Oh my god.
Wait, what happens if I touch it? Should I touch it? You shouldn't touch it. It might be bad.
These touch skits, it, it though. Might be good.
I'm gonna risk it.
Why am I treating it like a psychedelic drug? Oh yeah, this is MLG. This is my parody of LSD by ASAP Rocky. Oh god.
I think about her all day. I think about her with my Tim's on.
With my Tim's on.
My Stan socks lurking with some MLG. I find ways to say I sus you.
I sus you? What does that even mean?
But I'm into making Shrek songs.
I'm into making Shrek songs. I think Shrek songs would be like Smash Mouth, Sugar Ray, all like the Y2K and late 90s alternative rock.
Baby, I'm just rapping to this MLG.
That ad lib in the background. Sus.
I introduce her to the story lights.
To the story
lights. Well, when Supreme and Tim's MLG. These are the FPS, some other fight. I need something to get me hype. Girl, follow me with some dank edgy memes.
What kind of pickup line is that? I swear to God.
To me it's worth the sus. No, I'm waiting for the bus. Head to New York or bus. Royal Versace a must. Skate highs and pinnacles a must. It's worth it all cause I got dank edgy memes.
Wait. Was that my band director? I sampled him in the background. Truly amazing.
It started with symphonies.
Oh god.
Then when I went to Berlin, then I became an artist. To myself ignoring towards the bliss. Dreams of our fame. To be like Meek Mill was so late.
Come on, dude. Like the Meek Mill slander has to end someday. The love was edgy to be tamed. Whew. Going out with these alpha lines, like for real.
But at the end, it was so dank.
Oh man, I needed a good laugh. That was hilarious.
Adam, so, work. first started doing magazines.
Oh, no. No, 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 no. I actually sampled Lex Steele's interview in this. What the heck?
And then from the magazines, that led to meeting a producer that was out of the Bronx.
What is going on? I think one of the audio clips is him auto-tuned and the other one just distorted. Can I even play this? I don't want it to get age restricted. What did I create? I created a monster. Was that the... What's it called? Kahoot? Was it Kahoot? What is that sound? I know that sound from somewhere. It's like the sound effects in the background. Oh, I remember what that was. That was actually Superfet. He was just making noise on a bass guitar, and I just recorded that, and I just tossed it on the beat. Why do I keep using that sound? Came out with another one. Sammy more savage than 21. Why did we face that we get it done? FFNS, we be having fun. That produce the sub bass. I said my wrist, I seen the cake. Too much sauce for you stupid scrubs. Critics just hit up Crispies for some grub. I'ma come out with banger after banger, heavy metal whip. This beat like is a ridiculous, flare, but like I love flare. It. I'ma be like White Clef playing guitar. White Clef? Come out of filthy Frank's foreign car. Stupid scrubs under S. Pink Season. I remember Pink Season came out this time. Boy, what a time. My iron Tim's hard to levitate. Critics wrecked Master Chief. Critics wrecked Chief Keith Hendrix like I'm white. What is that sound in the background? Cliff Jean, I got. Oh my god. Bling in my DNA and hanging out my DNA. Oh my god, I just remembered. Brian told me to make a song and add Kanye's screaming and like progressively get louder. What a transition, am I right? Oh, this also samples Kanye. Is that DJ Khaled? Yeah, it's him. Is that Big Nasty? Oh, God. I think I just wanted to make a compilation and include every meme. Is that supposed to replicate Ty Dolla Sign Took? The samples used at the end too. I just recycle a lot of these. Wait, what was that? What was the slapping sound? Where did I get that from? Oh my god, that is so loud! bro, when DJ Khaled was like another one, it just like completely erupted. Tory Lanez. Bro, when Tory Lanez's first album came out, I loved it a lot. I don't like Tory Lanez anymore, though.
We be sipping on a mountain. Bad man, we think, baby. Yes, I be the Luxus, babe.
Oh, yeah. I just wanted to imitate a Jamaican accent. Just kind of making fun of Drake making a fake patois.
No crazy, they're crying, baby. Even though for the first time when I stomped your face.
When I stomped your face. No, we're not condoning that. We're not stomping anybody's face. Tripping on the stairs of my bars? What?
Oops, my Tim's filling your face, baby. Oops, my memes are so dang, baby. Oops, my Tim's filling your face, baby. Oops, it be falling again, baby. Everyone is so sad sometimes. I don't know about you, but it ain't fine. If you love me, love me, love me, love me, love me, love me so soon, babe. If you need me, need me, need me.
Man, I wonder where this is going.
If you love me, so soon. If you love me, so soon. If you love me, so soon.
That's crazy. Wait, controller? I forgot this. I forgot I had a controller. Oh God, what is going on?
No one girl can satisfy me.
Oh, I just remembered. I wanted to imitate Tory Lanez. He made like a remix of Controller. I wanted to parody Tory Lanez, kind of making that fake Jamaican accent over that.
We need more means for CS team. I like DJ
and it parodies his own remix too.
Like Flea.
Super fat slap bass like Fiend.
Young controller. If a scrub come, he gets stopped over. Do it all over. I know it sound crazy, but man, I got the memes. CC's pizza one time.
Okay, so the CC pizza lore was basically like the squad. They actually went to like CC's pizza together and they just like made memes with that.
Come find them. Crick's cop some chairs. He stomped them.
Where's this going?
One time for the sus boys, and you know that 300 time kick scrubs, all they be one. Tell the team beat the first man. Sam better than Shmurda.
Better than Shmurda?
I've been waiting for you, baby. You need somebody edgy.
I've been waiting for you, baby. You need somebody edgy? Two words to live by. Man, that was funny. Oh my God, this is actually a super fit song. Abimel, at this time, he had like iRig that he got on eBay and he just recorded his bass guitar and his microphone on his phone. That's me playing the drums. I actually recorded myself playing the drums and that was like my first attempt. Oh my God.
Hey, come on, Superfit. I got something to show everybody here. Like, they want the real sus experience. We're gonna give them the sus experience.
I'm scared. That's me playing the drums again. I can't believe I actually added that to this. Am I trying to do some psych rock here? What? What? Wait, I think that's me on guitar as well.
That's what's up, bro. Woo.
This is psychedelic rock from Timu. I just realized I tried to make an attempt at the Jimi Hendrix experience, but this is beyond disrespectful to him. Wait, is that the Little Wayne solo? Yeah, it was like ding, ding, ding. He was just playing the two notes. I think that was me playing the Little Wayne solo. What? Wait, is that something?
These nuts.
Yeah, that's the experience. That if we ever have a psychedelic rock concert, it's gonna be this. Oh, I have an acoustic song. I forgot. And this is the Weeknd song Sidewalks, but I just said Suswalks. Everything I just put sus in it.
Don't you know that I'm the OG?
Oh god, I did not use auto-tune. I was thinking about using auto-tune, but I just used my natural voice, for better or for worse.
Don't mistake it when they mention Pusha T, and so many scrubs they think they tanked me. Fill in the blankets, home society, tankless to teamless. These scrubs they keep digress, memes on my doses, supreme is my closest. If you in the saucer, I'll be handed to ya. I don't give a sus if a scrub said what's it to ya. Started when I got finessed by Sam. I squared up and wrecked Clash of Clans.
Clash of Clans?
Critics batter, finesse, Sharkeesha.
Sharkeesha? Was this around the Sharkeesha era? That is just a strange reference to me.
See ya, wouldn't wanna be ya. Dangerous colorways produced by Fan. You stupid scrub, do you wanna ban? Suswalk saved my life.
What is this falsetto?
I need
This is me trying to passionately sing.
Super fat photoshops you heavy. Ding ding ding. Distort the image.
Don't tell me I try to imitate Kendrick as well. Wow, nobody's safe. Like The Weeknd and Kendrick.
To make it look scary. Bing bing bing. Critics looking up to his hero, Chiefy. Hey, hey, hey. Now you know I'd be more savage than Leafy.
Chief Keef and Leafy? Oh my god. What a time it was to be alive.
The script will keep hating and staying full of lies. Their dignity compromised. You gotta be kidding. Once the mic drops, they're gonna put on a facade. Screenshot, distort their image in Photoshop. No. I need Moses.
Yeah, how about no? Wow. That was interesting. Another Tory Lanez parody?
What if I told you you're like the insole in my Timbs?
The insole in my Timbs? I had a reverb to this beat too. Why the voice sounds funny as it is. I still watch your Timbs and roses. Oh, you'll be back with me. Oh, what is going on? Like the harmonies are like one is ahead and the other one is a bit behind. It's poetic. Distort sound. It just feels, I was just recycling a lot of the ideas, but I still wanted to parody a lot of the songs that I liked and that I wanted to do. And this is just like another one of those songs. Oh my god. This is the start of the skits. I gotta explain the lore in this one. Brian is at home. Somebody calls him and he's talking to somebody. And Brian's like, I'm about to risk it. You know, I'm about to commit some questionable acts. Right when Brian is talking to this guy, you can hear the police sirens, and they just bust down the door and apprehend him at that point. And then it turns into this whole escape heist arc, and you just gotta hear it for real.
Who is this? Yo, dog, ammo, bro. I'm literally about to risk it, bro.
Alright, you know what? I say you.
But I see over there. I'm gonna risk it.
Anytime I take this L, nigga.
This was actually a Twitch swatting that happened, and I just added here like if it was Brian. Matt City?
Hey, yo, the boy Critics, man, the boy Critics, bro, my man's Critics is a savage.
Critics copped another Civics, old boy didn't think he had a limit, nah, he didn't care about the digit.
Was I copying Drake's old flow?
Only making his hands reach the clinic. Wait a minute, that be our Fifi. Help her brother out, CC's Luigi. Y'all know Critics worldwide stomping on the ground. All these clowns even outside. That's why your forehead's inclined. Let me do the math.
Your forehead's inclined.
Oh, you gassed? Oh, well, bye. Critics was just at his pinnacle. Oh, what he did wasn't cynical. But he was born to finesse, even leaving a big mess. I guess you could say it was stress. He was at his moment, on it, clone it, pwn it, loan it, seize.
Damn, bro. Bro, that's
a- I think that was part of the song too, wasn't it? Like the original Mad City song? How topical.
Fifi up there, bro. Y'all gotta free my Fifi.
Y'all know Critics has no chill, and he does it for the thrill. Chill boy, he still will finesse you. The boy's super fed, still woke. Wake up from its slow poke. While he might not YTP, he still be lit like ODB.
He just ODB?
Took an arrow to the knee. Bad mom, we still those
boys. Oh my god, the Jamaican accent again.
You can't stop all our noise. He's about to change like Troy.
I know who Toro and Moy is, but who is Troy? Troy from High School Musical?
You look extreme with milk without soy. CC's trainer brings in the painter. Later, we're all too cuter, but you're a hater, so your edge is fader.
Your edge is fader? Oh my god, I actually forgot I sampled Albert on this. Before I released my debut mixtape, I forgot this. Zippity zap? Zippity zap, zippity zap. What was that from? I forgot. Yeah, it's just the hook.
Got him!
That was supposed to be the cell door just like slamming. Oh, yeah. Like these skits continue, they get funny. Okay, so this is the heist. This is where they break Brian out of prison. It's hilarious. You gotta hear this.
My pleasure. Hey, yo, B. I'm ready to pop your ass out the pen, nigga.
All right, bro. They think they got me, bro, but I'm not finished risking it, know what I'm saying? I'm gonna go back, all right? Just get your stuff ready, know what I'm saying?
All right, man, you risky motherfucker. The C4 is ready, man.
Where the fuck is this nigga's van, dog? I can't see. Shit. Oh, is that over there? Alright, let's go.
Hey, yo, nigga, my car's over here. Hey, yo, nigga, get in the car, bro. Get in the van, nigga. Hey, we get wrecked.
What is going on?
Hey, yo, Brian, hand me the AK, nigga.
The bass drop. Oh, man. That is just a masterpiece. That whole thing. Ooh, it was so good, man. That was probably my favorite skit that I've ever made because everything was so calculated. It's just hilarious. I love it. And when Abimel took out like the AK and just started shooting at the cops, and then he just uses like sub bass as his ultimate weapon to just like get rid of them.
After critics and Superfet successfully escaped the heist, they joined forces.
Bro, this damn song. It was really a Snapchat story, if I were to be honest. And I just turned that into audio and tossed it in here. It's like really one of those once-in-a-lifetime moments.
Just with three birdie turd in the sus trap house. And this is when they began to realize that they all had pinnacles. And this sparked the amazingness that nobody ever knew, which would be their ultimate point.
Okay, so with Critics Pinnacle, I remember dropping this and everybody was just like, what was this? And you know, they loved it. They were like, what is this, dude? I absolutely don't know what it is, but I like it. Okay, so I just added horns as a lot of the southern hip hop trap beats, huge horns, heavy like trap drums. Yeah, like the beat doesn't make any sense. It's just minimal. Okay, so I just try to like make an example of mumble rap here.
Sam, drop the beat.
Super fat on bass, killer basses. You don't get a boy, reckon has better basses. Gonna explode.
Why is the beat distorted?
Like a Galaxy 7, not like Soulja Boy, who be 24/7. Come on, mix directed by Michael Bay. Action packed, so no scrub, you can stay.
Galaxy on the track.
You don't seem to get it. Why don't you let me finish? Production like clams, casino. Spitting like Childish Gambino. Assassination, fun to pick the Grammy. That's it with the pack, that's Fanny. Sign me the good music. Random samples, you better pull it.
Again, hit type beat, high beat. Snapping my streaks, kill streaks. I'm MLG, I'm a bean, not like Barry. On the contrary, you're out of date like Barry. Hello, I'm Southern T, your special cup of tea. My bars will break the heaters. Follow me, cause I'm the leader. No ungrateful scrubs loud, get destroyed by my distorted sound. Battle hit up DJ Khaled in the studio. Make a major DJ alert, alert like I'm Coolio.
Rest in peace, Coolio. Oh, Lord. So this is Brian playing tuba. I just put my phone on like the tuba horn and Brian just started playing some random song. And I don't know how, but it just mixes perfectly with the beat. Just listen. I do care, I actually do.
Now you can go live with Meek.
Again with Meek Mill? Oh my god. We gotta have a Meek Mill counter.
Not trying to be rude, although it may seem cynical. But I won't stop until I reach Critics Pinnacle. Hey yo, Sam, turn up the auto-tune. My homie, you know I have to keep on working. Flaming hot Travis got these scrubs, oh they be lurking. I cannot stop now, don't be a clown, bars on the circuit. And I won't stop.
I use the thing again. Is that Brian again? Oh yeah, this is Superfet's Pinnacle. In the beginning, the beat, I just throw in the, what's that Chief Keef song? Was it Earned It? I think it was Earned It. I just throw in that beat and it just goes on Critics tuba. Doesn't sound in sync, but you know, still something. It's distorted.
Critics got a civics. Hold up, I'm not finished. Back at a game of critics, pin it, go. Boy, I'ma stomp you like a whack-a-mole. Boy, I'm the biggest ever since Trap Soul. I got the Yeezy boots right in the midsole. Fought your career again when it was Skyfall. I signed to good music, got the phone call. Didn't get your job in Black Ops. Critics about to troll you like you're golden locks. Sus a T, don't mistake me with Pusha T. No phony homie, been the real OG ever since OP, boy. Catch me outside.
Not Danielle Bregoli. Bro, this is what she was trending on Dr. Phil. Is that Squidward? Oh yeah, he said everybody's a critic because critics. Just saying, this is going to be a loud warning. I just remember what this is. Okay, wait.
Bro, it's time to get lit!
Man, this is just chaos. Abimel told me, like, dude, you gotta record my trombone. So I get my phone, you know, point it at the bell. He records it. I go on Audacity, and one part of the trombone, I changed the pitch to make it harmonize, sound like a power chord. I don't know why I wanted it to be like a power chord, as if it was like a guitar. And I just make one louder, the other one much more louder, and the other one the loudest. And I just combine that with the screaming meme. I can't really say the name of it, but yeah, that one screaming meme. And I just scream like Travis Scott in the shows. I'm just like, it's about to get lit. And I just use the Red Hot Chili Pepper jam session with Flea and the drummer. And just rap over it.
You stupid scrubs, I got a jazz bass. And some new Tim's to me your face. This T-bone be on fire. I'm royalty, so call me sire. Just pulled up in that Rolls Royce. Nice scrub, stop calling me Prince Royce. I'm the...
Oh yeah, I remember somebody, like, I just took like a selfie. And the dude was like, you look like Prince Royce. But in a way that was roasting me. I was like, what? That's just so random.
Bass special.
Ooh. I actually like the instrumental a lot. You know what? I'm thinking I should try to rap on this instrumental again, but have a more serious demeanor. Can't say I can't be silly, but be professional about it. Was that Obama? No, I'm not Obama, bro. What? I think it's because Brian was always playing the if stutter from Obama. I don't know why I thought I just added in there because Brian loves it. Literally, that harmony didn't resonate with like the key of the solo, but you know, it still works, I guess. Oh, I think this is, oh yeah, this is Samurai Sucks Pinnacle. This one I actually got copyrighted for it because, believe it or not, I had this on Spotify, but this song was copyrighted.
Sonic, started out with Tony Basis. I had to expand his faces. The guidelines couldn't trace it. My YTPs, I lace it. I told these scrubs to face it. Better than Pete, I made it. Started it.
Not PewDiePie. Like, the dude's a family man now. Come on, man.
Get a following, started trending before something. You get the following of Bing. Boy, I can also sing. Not the one dislike. Like Kite at night. I be trending on Twitter. Performing on Letter. Man can plan. Man clan. I clash. Super smash. Smash mouth. Distort in the bass. Just in case it's too late. See you, mate. Just a mere chance that your ears can't handle the frequency of Samurai CC's. Oh yeah, I'm about to hit a three-peat. The fans hating the mixtape on repeat. Boy, why you out here?
Wait, did the song sample the Skype sound effect or the uwu? I forget which one it was.
Complaining, you asked for this, here's a this. Just saying, critics is John Doe. Don't touch us cause we bros.
John Doe. I don't know why. I used to type Brian into the John Doe from the whole Roblox incident that happened.
But I got that big nerf block. So careful.
Okay, that one was perfectly timed. I forgot how spot on that one was.
Your mom, cause I saw. I know it may seem cynical, but this is Samurai Sucks Pinnacle.
Okay, so this one's called Father Stretch My Tim's Part 3.
I just wanna curb some people. I just wanna curb some
people. Man, this was probably like the biggest song we made. I swear to God. I'm sorry, this was really funny. Brian actually came up with the idea. He told me, you gotta use Father Stretch My Hands, progressively make it louder, and toss in Lex Steel in there. I just tossed him in there, and he's just perfectly in sync with the rest of the choir. It's just poetic. It's really beautiful.
God.
It's so distorted. It's so distorted. So yeah, I was just imitating Kanye and Kid Cudi.
I just wanna feel templated. If I ever suffocated, I am sorry. Tell me who in here can I relay?
I just curbed this mom.
I forgot they actually recorded the verse on the bus, which just makes it even funnier.
And she just beached my tail, and I fucking beached my tail. I'ma feel like an asshole. I was New York when I'm at the.
Okay, so this is supposed to be Eminem.
I don't wanna say nothing. My Tims are all bloody and something. I don't wanna say nothing. Remind me where I know you're from. I'm from Chirac, you're from Hope. You know it's just you want. I wanna wake up with you tonight. Give me some of that
morning. Scoping in the morning.
Oh my god.
Scoping in the morning. Got a curb stop you, babe. Scoping in the morning. Just wanna feel timbulated. I just wanna feel timbulated.
This performance is once in a lifetime. I don't think I'll ever do something like this again.
But me saying that makes a difference.
Okay, so this is where we predominantly use the Kanye sample. Like, it was really meant for this part right here.
The exact people I'm talking to. It's like, shut the fuck up. I will fucking laser you with alien fucking eyes and explode your fucking head. Shut the fuck. Try to write a rap. Okay, then.
Up in the boarding, Tims are wrong. Sorry I curbs on you and your friends. All the Tims, all the curbs. Spell I cup, market crash. Sorry you had a die.
Whoa, 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 whoa. Mark Crash. Sorry, you had to die. Ooh. Bro, that's pretty prophetic. I'm sorry.
I don't know. I'm a broke ass nigga. Can't afford my tens. Oh no.
I forgot I did the ad libs afterwards. Atlanta. Pick up a bit of a phantom. Oh, no. Phantom. Phantom. Check up a bit of a phantom. Oh, spell it up. Spell a man. Spell a man. Spell a man. Pick up a bit of a phantom. Spell a bit of a phantom. Pick up a phantom. Pick up a phantom. Pick up a phantom. Pick up a bit of a phantom. I'm going over there in the middle of the damn.
But I'm up a bit. I should feel it right now. Bam, bam. I just wanna feel it right now. Banner. All the teams for you.
Bro, like the bus is so noisy. Like the when it cuts off and comes back in, it's just chaos. And yeah, they just overlapped an audio. Oh my god.
As a dad. Yeah, supposedly you're sus.
Alright, that's the end. Oh my god, I forgot what an adventure this was. And I'm still surprised I was able to put this all together on Wi-Fi that was barely getting me there and on a laptop that wasn't really up to par. I guess when there's a will, there's a way. Oh man, this just gives me a good laugh because we just wanted to have fun, do whatever we wanted. And I felt I had like the vision to kind of make these parody songs. Whatever people think of it, it's just a work of art to me still for some reason. Because it's really where I started and it kind of taught me a lot of the stuff that I know now in music production. And when I go record my songs as well and produce. So without this, even though it wasn't really meant to be serious, I wouldn't be where I am today. Honest to God, it was really good going back to this because it really taught me a lot from where it started. What do you guys think about this mixtape? Please give me your thoughts in the comments. I'm more than happy to hear whether you like it or you don't. I'm more than willing to hear you out. All right, I think that will be it for today. Thank you guys for watching. I'm hoping to review more of my old music and kind of get you guys to where I'm at now. And that's that. Hope you all have a good day and I'm out.